British Airways has a great history, but it also has a great future. And if you look at the future is about young people today, it's about environment and doing everything that we can to sustain the environment for the future.
We fly so much, it's so important that we take a leadership position on doing all sorts of projects, both in the UK and overseas, to make sure that aviation has a future and responsible flying truly is for everybody.
For me, the answer is not stop flying. It's making flying sustainable, because it will be a poorer world if we can't fly.
I think this is a game changer. I think this is going to make a huge difference, and I'm really pleased that British Airways, we're demonstrating our commitment by putting our money into this project to ensure that what we believe is technologically feasible can become commercially feasible as well. It's very important for British Airways, and indeed for the whole airline industry, to demonstrate that our commitment to improving our environmental performance is real.
We set off on this path to look for new fuels and new ways to use those fuels that would actually be beneficial to the environment.
The whole industry is looking towards reducing the environmental impact of aviation. And part of that is being able to operate on renewable fuels that have a lower CO2 footprint.
6 years ago, I was sitting on a British Airways aircraft reading the Evening Standard, thinking, well, how are we going to put this project together? How are we actually going to acquire sustainable, affordable fuel? And there in front of me was the UK, and in particular London's abysmal performance with regard to how it handles its waste, and 55% back in 2008 was going straight to landfill.
The only waste that we're using is post-recycling material, and that normally typically goes to the landfill, and that's the kind of waste that we can convert into biojet fuel.
We're going to take 500,000 tonnes of waste and converting it into 50,000 tonnes of high quality jet fuel, 50,000 tonnes of road transport fuel, and also 20,000 tonnes of naphtha, which we can actually use in road transport fuel or in chemical production.
Solena Fuels is a company that I created. We are an offshoot of NASA technology. So we basically have found a way, by utilizing this very high temperature plasma technology developed for the space program, and then utilizing the existing technology like Fischer-Tropsch, and convert it into jet fuel.
The new Fischer-Tropsch technology we're using is very much a cutting edge technology. It was developed here in the UK with Lossis.
Solena has part of the technology that's necessary for that, but they needed our part as well. So they make the synthesis gas, we turn that into liquids. What we have here is the wax that comes straight out of the Fischer-Tropsch process. Lovely, clean-smelling, slightly sweet product, and that's what we then turn into the finished diesel fuel.
I tell my engineering colleagues it's kind of designer kerosene, because we can actually optimise some of the fuel qualities.
What I have in my left hand here is conventional diesel from a local garage. What I have here is diesel made from our Fischer-Tropsch process. You can see they are completely different colours. This one here is a much purer substance, and so we're making a synthetic fuel that's absolutely miscible with conventional fuel, can be used without any change to engines, but actually makes a much better product. In the past, gas to liquids has only been possible in a handful of plants around the world with very special circumstances, very big engineering resources, billions of dollars. What we've done is to make it available on a much broader scale.
What you see behind me is an obsolete oil refinery that will soon be knocked down. All of this equipment will be removed. And British Airways, with our partner Solena, are going to build a ultra-modern new refinery to produce a green biofuel for our aircraft. British Airways has committed to taking the product that will be produced from this new refinery over a period of 11 years. In effect, we're looking at about $550 million of commitment to this project.
We have to ensure that the fuel is indistinguishable from the conventional fuel that we have designed to operate on. This means that the fuel operates in every respect the same as a conventional fuel, and therefore engine performance, reliability and safety is not compromised. Clearly a lot of testing is required because the composition, although similar, may be slightly different, and we have to ensure that the fuel behaves under all conditions the same as a conventional fuel.
Right at the tail of most of our aeroplane, you'll find an auxiliary power unit. You can sometimes hear them running. It's particularly useful for us to test our biofuels and conventional fuels because you can run the test and use relatively small volumes of fuel. So we ran conventional, ordinary jet fuel through this APU and made those measurements. And we were then able to compare those results with the results for the new synthetic fuels and biofuels that we're testing in this programme.
Bioenergy has always been a very controversial topic, and especially so amongst environmental organisations. But as we said in our International Energy Report a couple of years ago, we do see bioenergy as playing an important role in a transition towards a sustainable and renewably powered future.
The legacies that you always want to leave is something for the future, and sustainability and an airline that is interested in the future of air travel, for me, is where we need to be.
As an industry, we've set ourselves tough targets. We're looking to improve our fuel efficiency by 1.5% per annum to 2020, then to have carbon neutral growth from 2020, and by 2050 to reduce our net emissions by 50%. Now, these are very challenging targets, but if we're to convince people that we are truly going to be sustainable from an environmental point of view, these are the sort of targets that we have to set and meet. So we're playing an integral part in getting this project off the ground and literally into the air.
GreenSky represents the first step, albeit a small step, the first step to fueling the sustainable future for British Airways.